Hi, I'm Dr. Jim Bales. I'm the Associate Director at the MIT Edgerton Center, and I'm the lead instructor for our summer program, High-Speed Imaging for Motion Analysis, Systems, and Techniques. We'll be offering it this summer between June 17th and June 20th here on the MIT campus in beautiful Cambridge, MA, and we hope to see you there. What I want to show you today is a technique known as Schlieren Imaging, and the vast majority of people who need high-speed imaging don't need Schlieren, but when you need it, there's no replacement for it. Schlieren is a technique that allows you to see changes in the composition of a transparent medium or in its density. For example, here's a candle, and we'll light the candle, and now, so there's a column of hot air rising up off this candle, but when we look, we don't see the hot air. Yet we might be in an application where it's important to know where the air is warmer or colder, or we want to see how that air is flowing. Is it coming up in a laminar column? Is it coming up turbulently? And so the Schlieren techniques allows us to image the flow of the air that we can't see by eye. There's several elements to the Schlieren system. There's the light source over here. It's a structured light source that we're using. There are lots of ways of structuring the light source. The way we're doing it is we're making four glowing colored bars of light, blue on top, yellow on the bottom, red and green on the sides. That light will come out and it strikes a telescope mirror over here that captures the light and turns it into a collimated beam, parallel light rays, rather like a pipe of light that's coming along here around the candle and hitting the second mirror. The light that hits the second mirror comes back and focuses down to form an image. You may be able to see that image right here with the four colored bars. And then right there, I have a set of knife blades. I have a second pair here off frame. The knife blades right here allow us to adjust a square opening. And if I'm very, very careful, I can set it up so that the image here ends up falling right on the four knife blades. And at that point, I've gone to great length and spent a lot of money to make a system that will block all the light and we'll get a black image on the end. Once we've done that and we've built the system that will keep all the light from getting into the camera so we get a black image, in a perfect world, we now introduce an imperfection. In this case, the imperfection is that column of hot air coming up here. And of the light passing through, some of the light ray will hit this side of that column and they'll get bent away to the right. Others will get bent away to the left. Back at the aperture, that means light rays that otherwise were going to fall on one of the knife blades can get through. And this sort of nulling system is a very, very sensitive system indeed. And if you look, you see right here, we see the red and the green lines which mark the edges of that column of hot air coming off the candle. If we stir up the air a little bit, like this, you start seeing the swirls and the other colors, the yellow and the blues, show up as well. Schlieren is a very powerful technique. It's well suited for high-speed imaging, despite the fact that it's a low-light system. And come to the class, and we'll teach you more about it.